time in the original program, and they come in here in seventh place.
Well, as Carla said, this is their strong point. The long program is definitely their strongest point. And watch her on her throws. She's unbelievable. She has this cat-like ability to land from great heights.
Now that had the potential for real disaster. That's almost the same thing that happened to Huff and Ledre, but here they're gonna go right into the throw, triple jump, two-footed landing, but going back to that twist, he was so cool in his ability to prevent the two of them from tumbling over top of each other.
That was almost the same type of fall that Huff and Ledre had last year at Nationals.
Problems from the very beginning after the difficulty with that opening twist, and I have to wonder, as much hype as this team would have received coming from the United States of America with the story they've had, if they're not feeling the pressure here this evening.
Paul, that's exactly what Peter Jensen mentioned to me, that there is so much expected of them, that their horizons were broadened so much that they might have lost focus in the original program, and it seems to have continued here.
Well, it's so hard. We all know what that American media machine is like, and they have definitely had their fair share here in Albertville.
Very difficult lift. They call that the pendulum lift. And virtually, he lifts her from the bottom all the way to the top without her assisting him at all. That's what I mean about cat-like. I can't believe she landed that.
She gets so much height in that particular throw. It's amazing that she has the ability to break out and stick the landing. They're going into the last minute of their program, and interestingly enough, from U.S. Nationals, they've redone this entire last minute. They felt that the program didn't finish strongly enough musically, went home, inserted this minute, and they're hoping that it's going to be enough to push them through home, but they've already had too many mistakes to make any moves here this evening. Performance, and they'll be lucky to hold where they are.
They had a dream about winning a medal, but they'll have to be content with the dream of competing at the Olympics. Well, clearly they are not pleased, although they are getting a rousing ovation from the very loyal fans from the United States, but this was not the week that Urbanski and Marvel had expected.
Well, here we're gonna look at that twist in replay. Now, it appears to go up fine. It gets good height. He catches her, but her foot, she hits heel first and therefore falls immediately backward. But he composed himself enough to pick her up instead of falling on top of her, which could have really been not a pretty sight.
Here they go into the throw triple loop immediately afterwards. Gets good height, and she just, I think she just wanted to play it safe and land on the 2 feet there.
Well, the difficulty that they had with the twist showed throughout the program. They never did regain their composure. Well, they certainly are an exciting team to watch. And when they do a good performance as they did at U.S. Nationals, they certainly can put on a show.
Well, the variance in marks from the 4-8 from the British judge up to 5-3s. And the American fans not happy with that set, but I'm sure Calla and Rocky understand why those marks are as low as they are. Their coach, Ron Luddington, was a bronze medalist in 1960 when Wagner and Paul were the gold medalists in Squaw Valley.
She just mentioned there that they'll be back for Worlds, and that's one thing I like about this girl. She is not a quitter.